come join us here at the CabaRay.
That's the Ray Stevens CabaRay and Showroom right here in West Nashville. We're easy to find at the Charlotte Avenue exit off I-40 West. It's the place in Nashville for a special entertainment and dining experience. There's great food, all your favorite wines and mixed drinks, a fun piano bar where you can sing along and dance. And there's the Ray Stevens Show, where I'll sing all my biggest hits with Nashville's best musicians and singers. So whether it's a special date night, entertaining friends and family, or you're just coming out to sing along in the piano bar, whatever your reason, the CabaRay is a fun place to enjoy a full night of entertainment. And the parking is free. So come see me, Ray Stevens, at the CabaRay. Call 615-327-4630 or go to raystevenscabaret.com. Make your plans now.
And now from the Ray Stevens Studios in the heart of Music Row in Music City, USA, it's Ray Stevens, CabaRay Nashville.
My heart keeps going back to Nashville. That's the only place for me. My lover's waiting there in Nashville. Nashville, Tennessee.
With Ray's guest, Gary Mule Deer. And the A-Team. Boogity, boogity. Here he comes again. It's Ray Stevens.
Thank you.
Do you remember in the fairy tale how the wicked witch's spell changed the handsome prince to a toad? Through the power of her potion, she handed him notion he was lower than the dirt in the road. And though she left him green and warted, her evil plan was thwarted when there chanced to happen by a young miss, who in spite of his complexion offered her affection and broke the wicked curse with her kiss. Well, if you've never been from Kissin, and you don't know what you've been missing, oh, there's a world of opportunity under each and every law. And if you've never been a charm breaker, if you've never been a handsome prince maker, well, just slow down, turn around, bend down and kiss you a frog. Once upon a time ago, I was down and feeling low, like a lonely frog in a pond. Oh, life was just a joke, and I was very near a croaking. I was zapped by life's wicked wand. Then in the depths of my depression, there came a true expression of love from a lady so sweet. She gave me warm, fuzzy feelings, feelings that were healing, and knocked me off my little web feet. Now if you've never been from Kissin, then you don't know what you've been missing. Oh, there's a world of opportunity under each and every law. And if you've never been a charm breaker, if you've never been a handsome prince maker, well, just slow down, turn around, bend down and kiss you a frog. Now there's a happy ever after land deep in the heart of man where a prince or princess abides. But all we get are glimpses of the handsome prince or princess, cause they're covered by a green warty hide. And though they're full of life's potential, they're lacking one essential to enable them to shine like a star. And that's to have some guy or missus smother them with kisses and love them just the way that they are. And that's the secret of frog kissing. And you can do it too if you just listen. There's a world of opportunity under each and every law. If you've never been a charm breaker, and if you've never been a handsome prince maker, well, just slow down, turn around, bend down.
you a frog. I said, just slow down, turn around, bend down and kiss you a frog.
Ribbit, ribbit.
Welcome to the show. That was a song that I produced on Chet Atkins singing years ago. And then George Burns recorded it. A funny little song. And we got a lot of funny stuff to come. In fact, that song might be as serious as we get on this show tonight. But hang on, because here we go. Now, here is a funny guy, one of my favorites. And if he's not already one of yours, he soon will be. Ladies and gentlemen, Gary Mule Deer.
Thank you, Rick. Thank you. Just walking around the parking lot, it's windy out there.
The taste of love is sweet. When hearts like ours meet, I feel for you like a child. Oh, but the fire went wild. I fell in.
A couple of months ago, checked into a hotel, there was a Bible beside the bed. I opened it up, there's a message inside that said, if you are an alcoholic, if you think you have a drinking problem, please call this number. I called it, it was a liquor store. Let it out, folks, doesn't get any better. My grandpa used to say, listen, if we all liked the same things, everybody would be after your grandma. Grandpa used to say some weird things. One time I said, Grandpa, what's the quickest way to get to the lake? He said, you're walking or driving? I said, I'm driving. He said, that's the quickest. Make fun of Grandpa. Actually, he was pretty successful. He was a veterinarian and a taxidermist. The sign said, no matter what happens, you'll get your dog back. You guys are all right. Want to go to Denny's later? Took Grandpa to Denny's one time. The coffee was cold, eggs were runny, the hash browns were soggy, the toast was burned. As we were leaving, Grandpa turned to the cashier and he said, my compliments to the photographer. Grandpa really hated Grandma's cooking. He said it got so bad there for a while, all the flies chipped in and got the screen door fixed. You guys are all right. It's turning out much better than I thought it would. My name is Gary Mule Deer. It's not my real name. I changed it. My real name's Elizabeth Mule Deer. I remember one time when I was in Sunday school, I was trying to look up this little girl's dress, and the teacher caught me. She said, Gary, would Jesus do something like that? I said, well, no, he'd probably just create a big wind and blow the whole thing up. All right, here we go. This work a test? Test check. 1, 2. Old couple walking down the street. Pigeon flies over. Lets one go. Hits the old man right in the forehead. The old lady says, geez, I wish we had some toilet paper. The old man said, what the heck for? He must be half mile away by now. Stuff works better down here. Guy walks into Sears with a seeing eye dog, goes into the men's department, picks up the seeing eye dog by the tail, starts swinging it around his head. Manager walks up, says, can I help you? He says, no, we're just looking around.
Well, since my memory left me, I've found a new place to dwell. It's down at the...
So this burglar is going through a bedroom. He hears this voice over in the corner say, Jesus is watching you. He turns around. There's no one there. Starts to unplug the television. He hears this voice again. Jesus is watching you. Takes out his flashlight. Over in the corner, there's a cage with a parrot in it. Burglar says, was that you? The parrot says, yes, it was. The burglar says, well, what's your name? The parrot says, my name is Moses. Burglar says, well, what kind of a family would name a parrot Moses? Parrot said, the same family that named our Rottweiler Jesus. Like dog jokes, huh? Great. Dog walks into a bar, climbs up on a bar stool, says, I'll have a beer. Bartender says, that's amazing. You should be in a circus. Dog said, why? Do they need electricians? It's a musician's joke, right? So this teacher is talking to her students about whales. She said, although the whale's a very large mammal, it has a very small throat, incapable of swallowing a human being. Little girl raises her hand and says, well, what about Jonah? He was swallowed by a whale. Teacher said, once again, large mammal, small throat, no danger whatsoever to human being. Little girl says, when I get to heaven, I'm going to ask Jonah. Teacher said, well, what if Jonah went to hell? Little girl said, then you ask him.
Whoa.
This couple's walking down the beach, 60 years old. They're celebrating their 40th wedding anniversary. A genie appears, says, I'm going to give you each one wish. Takes the wife to the side, says, what's your wish? She said, you know, I've always wanted to travel the world for a couple of years. Just like that, fistful of airline tickets, helicopter arrives to take her to a cruise ship. Genie turns to the husband, he says, what about you? He says, you know, I've always wanted a wife 30 years younger than me. And just like that, he was 90. Oh, husband and wife jokes, huh? All right. Here's one I've never done before. This is the first time for TV, stage, anything. This couple's Christmas shopping. Woman looks around, notices her husband isn't there anymore, calls him on the cell phone, says, where are you? We have a lot of things to do today. He said, you know that jeweler that we ran into at jewelry shop about 10 years ago and you fell in love with that diamond necklace? And I said I couldn't afford it at the time, but sometime I was going to get it for you. She got kind of teary-eyed. She says, yes, I do remember. He said, well, I'm in the golf shop right next door to that. So I guess I better close real quickly here. Mother walks into her son's bedroom, says, get up, it's time to go to church. He said, I'm not going. She said, get up and get dressed, you're going to church. He said, give me one good reason. She said, I'll give you three. Number one, I'm your mother. Number two, you're 52 years old. You've been living here ever since you got out of high school. And number three, you're the pastor. Thanks, you guys. You're incredible.
Hi, this is Ray Stevens with some great news. My CabaRay gift shop has gone digital. You no longer have to drive to Tennessee to see all the stuff we have for you to enjoy and buy. Take your time and take a nice long look around at all the ball caps, t-shirts, monkeys and squirrels. We have keychains, cups, mouse pads, and books, CDs, DVDs, and so much more. Everything we have in the gift shop is now available to you here online. So fill up that shopping cart.
Now, when I heard the sound of Johnny Cash and Sun Records in the 1950s, I wanted to get into show business. I almost didn't get to hear the sound of Johnny Cash and Sun Records. You didn't either. You don't realize this, but in 1955 in Los Angeles, California, Frank Sinatra was working on a song that went something like this. I hear that train a-coming, dooby-dooby-dooby-doo. That exact same time in Memphis, Tennessee, Johnny Cash was working on this song. Start spreading the news, I'm leaving today. I want to be a part of it, New York, New York. Thank God they switched songs. I hear that train a-coming, it's rolling around the bend. I ain't seen the sunshine since I don't know when. Yeah, I'm stuck in Folsom Prison. Time keeps dragging on. Toby keeps a sissy. But that train keeps rolling on down to San Antone. When I was just a baby, my mama told me, son, always be a good boy, don't ever play with guns. But I shot a man in Reno, yeah, just to watch him die. When I hear that whistle blow, I hang my head and I cry. Let's hear a little bit of Luther here.
sit down in car. They're probably drinking coffee and smoking big cigars. Well, I knew I had it coming. I know I can be free. But those people keep a moving, and that's what tortures me. One more time, let's play that one. Pretty good, isn't it? I bet I'd move it on a little farther down the line. Yeah, far from Folsom Prison, that's where I want to stay. And I'd let that lonesome whistle blow my blues away.
That was great. Sounds just like Cash to me, I'd say. But, you know, I have some good stories about Roger Miller, too.
Oh, boy. I got some stories about Roger. I worked with Roger for 7 years on the road. Roger gave me a show business tip once. He said, never play in your hometown, never take a wood into a sand trap, and never carry your picks and your pills in the same box.
Well, you know, he used to... take a few pills, I understand.
Yes, he did. Roger and I used to spend a lot of days up. We used to go to bed on Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. It was amazing.
Well, you know, when he walked, he sounded like a maraca. Yeah.
Yeah. I remember one time we were working in Atlantic City at the Claridge Hotel in Atlantic City, and they asked him to be the head of the Easter Parade. They wanted to be the Grand Marshal of the Easter Parade. He said, if I do it, Mule Deer has to do it. So at 7 a.m., we're out on the boardwalk, and it's cold on the ocean. And there's three vintage cars. There's Roger and Mary Miller will be in the first car. The mayor of Atlantic City and last year's Miss Atlantic City and Miss Atlantic City in the very back of the car. And the third car was the water commissioner. They said, well, where's Mule Deer going to ride? So they took the water commissioner out, took the sign off, and we're going up and down the boardwalk, like 10 miles an hour, freezing. And nobody knows who I am because I have no sign on the side. Just as we're making the turn to come back down the boardwalk, some lady yells to me, who are you? I yelled, Pia Zadora. She yelled back, your movie sucks.
Well, you know what I like about you, though? You don't use any four-letter words in your act.
No, I don't, man. I just never have. But I have four-letter words all around me. My name is three four-letter words. Gary Mule Deer. I mean, I play golf. I think about joke. I think about sing, show, play, all the stuff that are four-letter words, but that's the only ones I use. I don't think adult humor is very grown up.
I don't know. I do this, and that's why I'm going to bring out the fact that you carry a lot of notes in your pockets.
Oh, man. Oh, yeah.
We were talking before the show about the hillbilly teleprompters. And, turns out he has one, too. He didn't know what to call it, though.
How men and women record things in their diaries. Tonight I thought my husband was acting weird. We had made plans to meet at a nice restaurant for dinner. I was shopping with my friends all day long, so I thought he was upset at the fact I was a bit late, but he made no comment. Conversation wasn't flowing, so I suggested we find a table in the back so we could talk. He said, fine, but nothing else. I asked him what was wrong. He said, nothing, don't worry about it. On the way home, I told him that I loved him. He smiled slightly, patted my arm, and kept driving. I don't know why he didn't say, I love you too. When we got home, I felt as if I'd lost him completely. He just sat there quietly and watched TV. Finally, with silence all around us, I just went in and went to bed. 15 minutes later, he came in, rolled over, and went to sleep. My marriage is in a shambles. I've been crying for an hour. I don't know what to do. Husband's diary. A 2-foot putt. Who in the hell misses a 2-foot putt?
Oh, God. Listen, I got to ask.
We've been out here a while. Let's see what's going on in the news real quick here. It says scientists now tell us that the fastest animal on Earth with a top speed of over 120 feet per second is a cow that's been dropped out of a helicopter. Terrible. So bad.
Who were your influences?
Jack Benny. I influenced Ray. Jack Benny, Eve Arden, they were my two comedy influences. Johnny Cash, of course, I learned to sing with his records. But I never hung out with comedians a lot. When I started doing comedy, I did 15, 20 years, 25 years in comedy clubs. But I was always I was never a stand-up comedian. I always hung out with guys like you, funny musicians. That's who I liked. I liked guys like, well, Jack Benny was a funny musician. But I liked the Smothers Brothers. I liked Steve Martin. I liked...
Got a question. Were you and Steve Martin roommates
yes,
at one
we
time?
Yes, we were, as a matter of fact. We were roommates during when he was writing the Smothers Brothers show. As a matter of fact, he couldn't write anything, and Tommy came up and said, you've got to come up with something, Steve, for this bit in the show. We're going to have to let you go. So he called me, and I had two things in my show. He says, can I use them? I said, sure, and he went back. And I one of them was, female impersonators are great on dates because they can change tires. And I can't remember the other one, but anyway.
Well, you know, Steve Martin was a writer on my show.
I know, that's right.
In 1970.
That's right, he did.
I thought he was the strangest guy I'd ever met.
He's a very strange guy, but I'll tell you, you know, incredible banjo player, incredible musician.
Oh, yeah, he is.
And the absolute best.
He came up with the arrow through the head
on
my show, as well as a lot of the other things that have become synonymous with the name Steve Martin.
That's right, and that's why I take the arrow now and shoot it. I tape a rubber chicken to the microphone, put a cigarette in his mouth, walk off 30 feet, and using my guitar as a bow, I shoot the cigarette out of the chicken's mouth.
Can you really do that?
I really do that, honestly. Really,
on stage?
Yes. Speaking of musicians.
And you never miss?
No, I never miss. Speaking of musicians, look at this. I can't believe this. Look what this says. 5 rules for men to follow for a happy life, according to all the guys in the Ray Stevens Orchestra. Listen to this. Number one, it is important to have a woman who helps at home, who cooks from time to time, cleans up, and has a job. Number two, it is important to have a woman that can make you laugh. Number three, it is important to have a woman who you can trust and who doesn't lie to you. Number four, it is important to have a woman who is nice to sleep with and who likes to be with you. And number five, it is very, very important that these four women do not know each other.
Thanks for being here, Gary. It's been a lot of fun. Ladies and gentlemen, Gary Mule Deer.
Thank you all. Great. Thanks,
come back to me, cause I'm through with you. Cause baby, now that you've done me wrong, it's plain to see that you no longer want a part of me. I'm sick and tired of all your lying and your cheating, and the way that you have been mistreating me. And let me tell you, friend, you'll never get the chance to break my heart again. And furthermore. And on top of that, I don't love you anyway. Told me that you'd always love and treat me fair, but lately, baby, seem like you don't even care about me anymore. You close the door on me and left me blue as I can be, and I not gonna take it anymore. Be a fool again like I was before, but baby, this is it. I quit. You can just forget that we ever met. And furthermore. And in addition to that, I don't love you anyway. No, baby,
baby,
I don't love you anyway.
Love you anyway.
Love you anyway.
Love you anyway.
At least.
At least.
At least.
At least.
That's what I say. While all the while I'll be trying to hide tears welling up deep inside. So go your way and leave me all alone and blue, and never come back to me, cause I'm through with you. But baby, now that you have done me wrong, it's plain to see that you no longer want a part of me. Sick and tired of all your lying and your cheating, and the way that you have been mistreating me. And let me tell you, friend, you'll never get the chance to break my heart again. And
furthermore,
and on top of that, I don't love you anyway. Thank you. You know, years ago, during the Beatlemania rage, kids would play Beatles records backwards and claim that they received secret messages. And you know, I heard about a country boy played a Vern Gosden record backwards, and his wife came home, his old dog came back to life, and the repo man brought back his pickup truck. Thanks for spending this last 30 minutes of your life with us. We hope we gave you a laugh or two, because it's awfully good for your health. Tune in next time for another big dose of music and laughter here at CabaRay Nashville. Now, pardon me, ma'am, but I believe your name is on my dance card. Would you honor me by this day? Won't you get to the home?
This is Bill Cody saying so long until next time from CabaRay Nashville.
Come join us here at the CabaRay. That's the Ray Stevens CabaRay and Showroom right here in West Nashville. We're easy to find at the Charlotte Avenue exit off I-40 West. It's the place in Nashville for a special entertainment and dining experience. There's great food, all your favorite wines and mixed drinks, a fun piano bar where you can sing along and dance. And there's the Ray Stevens Show, where I'll sing all my biggest hits with Nashville's best musicians and singers. So whether it's a special date night, entertaining friends and family, or you're just coming out to sing along in the piano bar, whatever your reason, the CabaRay is a fun place to enjoy a full night of entertainment. And the parking is free. So come see me, Ray Stevens, at the CabaRay. Call 615-327-4630 or go to raystevenscabaret.com. Make your plans now.